Hello everybody, my name is Travis. I'm your Santa Clara County Parks Interpreter, and today let's take a deep breath and dive right into it.
Have you ever wondered where all this oxygen came from? If you guessed plants, then you nailed it. But did you know that if it weren't for one tiny little bacteria, all of life as we know it today wouldn't even exist? Well, I'd like to take you all into a deep dive into the realm of that bacteria known as cyanobacteria, or as it's more commonly known, blue-green algae or pond scum. Cyanobacteria can take on many forms. Typically, it's green, sometimes it's reddish-brown, but if there's a lot of it, you'll often see it floating at the top of the water's surface. Although it's commonly called blue-green algae, it's actually a bacteria and not a plant. And its origins date back to billions of years ago, when life on Earth was first getting started.
Back then, Earth looked very different to how it is today. The world was almost entirely ocean, and you and I would have had a very hard time living because there was practically no oxygen in the atmosphere. But that all changed when ancestors of cyanobacteria evolved a handy little technique to generate their own energy by using the power of the sun.
Do you know what that technique would be? If you guessed photosynthesis, you're right. As nature's first solar panels, these little cyanobacteria would take the light from the sun and use that energy to combine carbon dioxide and water to form sugar for them to use and oxygen into the atmosphere.
Today, plants use a tiny little internal factory inside their cells called a chloroplast. But how did they get those chloroplasts? Well, if you can't photosynthesize on your own and make your own energy, what else could you do to get that energy? Yes, that is right. Cells would do their best Pac-Man impression and eat other cells to get that energy for them.
However, that changed for plants through a process called endosymbiosis. Back then, some ancient plant cells came across cyanobacteria, and instead of digesting it, the cyanobacteria became a part of that plant cell, eventually forming today what is known as the chloroplast.
These ancient ancestors to plant cells and the ancestors to cyanobacteria were now actually helping each other, because the cyanobacteria now had a home to live in where they wouldn't have to worry about getting eaten by other cells. And the cyanobacteria now had a place where they can photosynthesize, and the plant cells didn't have to worry about eating other cells to get their energy. Over the next millions to billions of years, cyanobacteria bloomed and produced so much oxygen that it changed Earth's atmosphere to be what it is today. And with that, life as we know it took its first breaths.
Thank you everybody for watching our video today. I hope you all enjoyed it. And next time you're here at one of our Santa Clara County parks, like here at Cottonwood Lake, make sure to come by and appreciate the little things. Or let us know in the email on screen if there was ever a time in nature where something small had a profound impact on your life, much like cyanobacteria did for all of life. And of course, check out our website, parkhere.org, to stay safe with all our different updates to make sure your visit is the best it could be. And of course, happy trails and goodbye.